So in today's tutorial, we're going to talk about the humble histogram. So in my first cell here in my Jupyter notebook, I'm just importing my cascading style sheet as per usual, just to get away from this bland looking black to just something a bit more interesting. There we go. If I run the cell, we see these nice little colors and different fonts for the markdown that is used. So let's set up the library. I'm going to import from plotly.offline my iplot so that I can plot directly in this Jupyter notebook, and to the init notebook mode just to initialize the notebook. We did that with the previous tutorial on the bar chart. We're going to do exactly the same here. And again, we're going to make use of one of the high level charts. So we're going to do plotly.graphobjects as GO. We'll do that import as well. Now for this case, I just want to generate some random values. So I'm going to import the random module, the Python random module. So that's very easy, import random. And I also want to import the numerical Python library, numpies. And I'm going to use this namespace abbreviation. So I'm going to say import numpy as np. Now I'm going to just seed this pseudo random number generator so that we get the same results every time we generate these random values. And I'm just going to seed it with a value 1234. And there we go. So let's create a few random values. My first variable here is called age. And I'm going to just use a uniform distribution. I'm going to say np for numpy.random. So I'm doing the random module in this numpy library. And from there, I want the uniform distribution. My lowest value must be 21. My highest value is 75. And the last argument here, size, meaning I want 100 values from that distribution. The next one, I'm just going to use the computer variable salary. Again, that's numpy.random. And this time from a normal distribution. I want the mean, which has the argument LOC, to be 3000. I want the standard deviation, which is the scale argument here, to be 1000. And again, the size, the number of samples I want drawn, being 100. Now I'm just going to use a choice between, just purely for the sake of simplicity, use a gender, a binary gender here, just for purely for the sake of simplicity, we use, and I'm going to create the computer variable binary gender, and I'm going to use from the random module, I'm going to use random.choices. And what you can do with this choices function is just to pass a list of all these various text, the string elements that you want to choose from. So I've got female then male, and I'm going to say draw at random 100 of those, and it is drawing that at random with replacement. So the first one might be female, it puts female back in the box, draws another one blindly out of the box, that might be female again, throw it back. So 100 of those choices. Now I want to place these inside of a pandas data frame. It's a beautiful thing to use. I urge you to have a look at pandas. I'm going to import pandas and use the abbreviation PD. And I'm doing that because I want to create a data frame. I'm going to call my data frame df, and I'm going to call the data frame function here, pd.dataframe. And I'm going to create this data frame out of using a dictionary. So I'm going to have this age column, and underneath that age column, think of a spreadsheet. So the header in the first row, I have my header values, my variables, and I'm going to call this first one age. And down that column, all the rows are going to be populated by these 100 age values. The salary is going to be the next column header in my spreadsheet, basically, which was what a data frame can be seen as in a simplistic way. Pass all the 100 salary values and then gender this binary gender values of mine. So let's run that, and I've created a data frame. And I'm going to split my data frame in two, one for female and one for male. And the one that we're going to do, the way we're going to do that, create these two computer variables, female and male. The first one says, take this data frame, and then we're going to use this square bracket notation because it wants to run down row by row. So I'm just indexing this df.gender column. So it's going to look down the gender column and only select those. So this is a Boolean double equal sign, only the females. And then male will only be contain the male. So I have two data frames now, female and male. So let's create our first bare bones histogram now that we have some data. Again, per usual, just by convention, I'm going to use this trace computer variable, and it's go because this was a graph object, one of the high level graph objects, and it's a histogram. I'm going to pass it the x value because let's just stop there for a moment. What, you know, just to discuss what a histogram is. Whereas a bar chart looked at categorical variables on the x-axis, the histogram is going to look at numerical variables. So age is definitely a numerical variable, a ratio type numerical variable, because there's a true zero. And we're going to split that up into little bins. And if we just pass the age here, Plotly will decide how large those bins are. So what are bins? Well, as soon as I show you the histogram, I can show you what bins are. Again, the computer variable data, and pass the list of all these histogram elements I want to put on my figure. And then instead of using go.figure, I'm just going to use this dictionary notation. So iplot and then data, please. And we see here, look at the bottom. These are numerical variables. It's not categorical. And what it's done is it seems to be having plot from 20 to 25, 25 to 30, 30 to 35, 35 to 40. And that's what I mean by these little bins. So all it's going to do, it takes those 100 values and it decides how many are between 20 and 25, and it'll count them, and it noted that there was 8. And between 25 and 30, there was 30. Between 30 and 35, there was 5. Between 25 and 30, there was 8, etc. And so it goes on. So that is why a histogram is not a bar chart. And what you can see here also, there is really no spaces between these, just to indicate that we're talking about a continuity here, whereas a bar chart by definition has these gaps in, just to create this visual impression that we are dealing with categorical variables, that this is not a continuum. And here we do have a continuous random variable at the bottom called age. Now let's just change that to a frequency distribution, or otherwise known as a normalized histogram, because what you can see on the top one here is we count how many were between 20 and 25. But if we normalize that, it gives us a frequency distribution. And the way that we do that is just by, in this histogram element that we create at the top, we pass a new argument, histnorm, and we pass to it this equals probability. I'm going to introduce a layout here by a dictionary format. So I have title and its frequency distribution of the age variable. And my x-axis, I'm going to bring in a title, also a dictionary with a key value pair, the value pair being a dictionary itself, consisting of a key and a value. And my iplot via a dictionary as well. And now we can see frequency distribution of age. I have age in 5-year increments here at the bottom. But most notably, you'll see now this is normalized. So the area under this curve, which is the area of this rectangle and this rectangle and this rectangle and this rectangle, is going to sum up to be 1. It's mutually, these bins are mutually exclusive but collectively exhaustive, so they are all here. And the area under this stepwise curve is going to be 1. So it's a frequency distribution. So I'll have to, if I want to get how many there are, this increment is 5 times 0.08 to get to the value that we have there, that we have. Well, let's have a look. So that was 8. So remember, these are now units of 1. So 0.08 times 100 is going to give you that 8. So let's create 2 in an overlay fashion. So to do that, I'm going to create 2 traces, by convention calling them trace 0 and trace 1. So go.histogram, and I have x equals female.age, and this time I'm going to give it a name so that we can have this little sidebar that indicates what is what. And the second one that I'm plotting, it's going to layer them from the back to the front. So the back one is going to be female, the one in front is going to be male. So I just want to lower the opacity of the front one so we can still see the bottom trace through that. So I'm going to set opacity equals 0.8. Everything else being the same, I'm bringing in my little layout there. And now we can see I've got 2 plots here. It's going to give me this little legend on the side. And I've created a bit of opacity here in the orange, which is the male, just so that this female at the back shines through. But if we hover over them, it's beautiful what Plotly does, and you can see that it's still going to give you the values. Let's stack them, so I don't have to do the opacity there, and it is just going to stack them, but it's still going to give me these values to say in male there was 4 and in the female there was 12. And look at one thing though, a difference that it made, it is now making these blocks of unit length of 10 years. So I've put in that as 10 years. That didn't that didn't influence that this was done. I drew this first and saw by, you know, automatically it chose 10 and I put the 10 in there after the fact. So let's do that. Let's control the bin size. And the way that we do that is by introducing inside of our traces here, we introduce the x bins argument. And I'm going to pass a dictionary for that in this format, not the curly braces format. So start is 20, end at 80. So just the left-hand side of the x-axis, the right-hand side of the x-axis, and I want a bin size of 5 units. I'm going to do the same for male, and I'm changing my title here to 5 because now I'm in control of it. And if we run this, we'll see that now we are back with this increments of 5. We're back with this increments of 5. Let's just do that again. This time we're just going to stack them. And just for argument's sake, this time I'm looking at female.salary and male.salary. And we have introduced a bin size of 200 here, starting at 500, ending in 5,500. And because we drew that from a normal distribution, you can see this tending towards this normal distribution. The last thing I want to show you just in this little tutorial is the cumulative histogram. And when you do statistics and you start looking at cumulative distribution functions, etc., this is important, but we're not dealing with that at the moment. This is just a histogram, and the way that I do that inside of this histogram object that I've created, I'm going to use the argument cumulative and pass to that a dictionary with a key value pair of enabled being true, and I use the dict function instead of the curly braces notation here. And if we just execute that, we see this beautiful stepwise. And we can see the larger steps here, meaning we are dealing with a normal distribution. You can see that from this cumulative distribution function. So that is that for the humble histogram. Remember, that is for numerical variables, and we're just going to start counting them or putting them in a frequency distribution by creating these artificial little bins, and we can control the bin size as I've shown you. So that's the histogram. I'll see you in the next lecture where we continue our look at this wonderful world of Plotly and this wonderful library, plotting library that Plotly is. Please, please, please remember to subscribe and hit the notification button, because that's going to allow you to know when new videos or new tutorials do come out. I'll see you again.